देर आर मेनी स्लाइड, सो थोड़ा जल्दी भी करना पड़ेगा. लेट मी ट्राई टू कंप्लीट विद इन 1 आवर. ओके, ऑलरेडी माय बायोडाटा आर ऑलरेडी डिस्कस, सो विल नॉट डिस्कस हियर. दिस इज माय पब्लिश बुक अलोंग विद माय सन स्मित देसाई एक्सपीरियंस ऑल्सो मेंशन एकेडमिक अचीवमेंट एंड दिस आर द नेम ऑफ क्लाइंट. ओके, नाउ इफ यू विल आस्क मी ओनली वन प्रोजेक्ट इन विच आई फील प्राउड, दैट इज स्वामीनारायण टेम्पल दिल्ली. इट वॉज डिजाइन बाई one of my sir, Dr. M.D. Desai. The main challenge was given to us, that is, we cannot use steel reinforcement bar. So here you can see a artificial boat of geotextile 22 feet deep was constructed below ground, and it was locked in the top lean concrete slab. A very simple theory was used, that is a single degree oscillation model. If you see, just by pencil calculation we can able to solve weight of temple, lean concrete slab, boat type structure and Yamuna River. So, and for earthquake loading, 0.4G earthquake loading was considered, and permissible amplitude of vibration was calculated, and the design was already there, we can say. And during inauguration time, 0.4G earthquake was recorded from Pakistan side, and it was inaugurated by our president, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, in those this time. So, this is one of the very finest structure in which no reinforcement bar was used, and it was erected. So these are diagram, 22 feet deep boat locked by geotextile, Yamuna River, stiffness was considered, and rainwater will percolate from this one, and nothing will happen during movement of groundwater level and other aspects. Quickly we see what are the reasons why in India earthquake occurred as far as geological condition is concerned. On the left side, corner side, you can see There is a Oman fracture zone, which is one of the very near to our Gujarat. That's why I'm discussing here. And this is called Ring of Fire. So in every 15 years, so every 15 days, my earthquake will be on the Ring of Fire anywhere, and it will be repeated many times. If we are talking about Surat, then there are two fault line, 103 kilometer long Kim fault line and Surat fault line. Surat fault line 206 km reaching to Billimur and reaching up to Saputara Mandav Khadak available. Of course, this is not active fault line, but may create problem if something will be going wrong here, then it may try to create tsunami problem in our area. We will see the bearing capacity variation. The bearing capacity variation is very broadly, it was done by one of the students. So you can see the soil is not same, bearing capacity is varying too much. So if you are designing any building, your structural design will be different from, if even in the same city also, a different bearing capacity you have to consider. Just for your thumb rule type of things are given here. Our Indian tectonic plate is moving at 50 millimeters in the northeast corner, and that's why it is going below Eurasian plate and rising mountain, that is called Himalayan mountain. Now the movement is almost stopped. The movement of the plate is stopped. So what happening? The plate folding is going, and that's why in the tectonic plate, in the Narmada plain and Gondwana plain, in the top fiber tension will occur, and it is one of the main reason why earthquake occurred in the Gujarat, or sorry, earthquake occurred in India. It is one of the main reason because of this one. This is a diagram because of the Bhuj earthquake, number of epicenter was activated surrounding is pre and post earthquake mapping is shown here. For Bhuj area, you can see the blue water passing below Bhuj. So these are thermal radiation images observed from the satellite, Japanese satellite taken these images. So we can able to see the cracking inside ground also by satellite images. This is also indicating a tsunami threat for Gujarat. 1600 kilometer long Gujarat coast is there. So if something, these are blue color is a deep ocean, is shallow sea portion, correct? So suppose something goes wrong here, then when it will enter here in this bay of Khambat and here, then the tsunami wave height will increase suddenly and may try to create problem in Gujarat. Our earthquake frequency are increasing in India and Gujarat also. So you can see the earlier 1893 earthquake fault, it was revised in 84, then 2002 after Bhuj earthquake, and again in 16 fault was revised. So it is giving very heavy design, and the factors are also increased. That's why our designing and enforcement consumption, everything are increasing. Now we are coming to geotechnical engineering aspect. you one of the best example that earth is hold by tree roots, correct? So it is a well known thing that a tree tree roots will hold ground very strongly, and it will not wash during cyclone, heavy rains. So if we will try to add some innovative material in earth, later we'll see in more detail, then it is possible to create a geotechnical structure very strong enough to resist earthquake and other forces also, because earthquake also occurring in underground structure also and in geotechnical structure also. These are the field examples are shown, it will be seen more detail here. So geotechnical structures are variable, very large applications are there in the aquatic part, road pavement, environmental aspect, rock field coastal protections area, then in the construction of highway, then basalt reinforcement for stability, road pavement, hydraulic structure, drainage structure, erosion control, tunneling. So this particular one picture shows you what is the importance of geotechnical engineering. And geotechnical engineering structure, if we are designing with different material, it is very, very cost effective as compared to RCC and steel. It is worth, many times it will be found that it is one third or one fourth the cost of the RCC structure. So that's why suddenly now, because as we are giving EPC contract, engineering procurement contract to contractor, they are interested in more and more economical as well as safe designing. So these are some of the innovative applications, and now you must learn in more detail particular geotechnical aspect and geotechnical engineering structure design. Here also photographs for retaining wall, for highway pavement, for designing runway designing, correct, hydraulic works. And these also one of the photograph from Goa, where RE wall structure was used for garbage storage and other thing, rock protections. So on the high mountain, there will be falling of rocks problem will be there. Then basalt, this platform for reinforcements will be provided. Solution for tunnels, RE wall. This is very economical as compared to RCC wall. So you can see the bridge structure is here, but here RE wall for abutment purpose is also. Later we'll go in more detail. RE wall structure is a vertical RE wall, 6 degree tilted, and these are other applications. 19 meter high RE wall was also constructed in Ahmedabad area recently. Now you can see the most important aspect that as compared to RCC, here geotechnical structures are very environmental friendly. You can see here after construction of this even gabion wall, very green facade we are observing. These from the Italy, where there some canal is going, the natural stone, the marble stone was taken and the gabion was erected for canal lining work. So it is also matching with the surrounding marble mountains. Teramis also used here. Teramis is the name of different company. They manufacture the gabion structure or the protection work. Here step gabions are used for slope protections and other aspects. In Sikkim also, the India tallest 73 meter tall end of the runway was supported by this technique. We have also done for Tapti River in Mandvi area, Rameswaram temple, where also 92 feet water protected by this particular mechanism in the bank of river Tapti for protection of Rameswaram temple. Gabion mattress are also used for low depth water. If the flow is high, then gabion and geotextile both can be combined used for protections of the work. And afterward, you can, there is green field you will find. It is not visible. My structure is not visible. Correct. And these are also sag gabion to be used for the base of a geotechnical structure. So here also for breakwater, for the sea intrusions problem can be solved by breakwater. And this one, you can see a complete jetty. It is also from the foreign country, Italian, France. We can see the gabion. There is no cement. There is no cement. No environmental problem, because cement produces a lot of carbon dioxide and monoxide in atmosphere. But here we are using a local stone and just a mesh, gabion mesh, and you can see a structure is erected and very economical and cost effective. Pipe for protection of pipe also, this type of structures are required. And these are reinforcement mesh, reinforcement wire mesh used for pavement and strengthening aspect. So very quickly, even we can strengthen a top surface of the road also. You can see the other technique here also. This is also from the Saptashrungi Mountains near Saputara, where the rock falling problem is there. So rock will be trapped here, and our highway and the state highway will be protected by this thing. Where it is very special mesh are even up to 610 Boulder, wait, it can be registered. It is a patented technology, 140 years old. In with the nailing will be there also, nailing and this one. Recently, in my visit in Japan 2 months back, we have seen that they are also using RCC structure, RCC frame meshing on the slope of mountain along with this gabion. So in a very high mountain in Japan, I have taken photograph also that they are using a combination of different technology, RCC as well as this one. Now, even what is the fundamentals of RE wall? In RE wall, this is one road and this is another road. Or suppose you are our national highway or state highway. So we use a RE wall reinforcement. RCC panel will be there. And for interlocking panel, we are putting a geotextile mesh here or the steel strip here. Okay. Now, what happening? That when because of the vehicle loading or the because of the friction between this geotextile strip and mesh, it will give a resisting force and that will not allow my RE wall to come out. Okay. Now in diagram it should be very simple. But when you will operate on computer software, more than 200 page is required because we have to design. When we design this one lumbar formation combination, different failure lines, then earthquake force, earthquake force. Submerged conditions, then very heavy surcharge weight is to be considered. So all combinations, load combination, vehicle only on one side, vehicle on both side, or no vehicles and only rain is there and earthquake is occurring. All the permutation combinations to be considered for designing RE wall. And it is a self-balancing mechanism. So if in calculation some error will be there, then immediately it will be. It is a very cost-effective, but what happening that it will break and will create problem for us. Now here. Different country RE wall is shown here. Okay, in a cold climatic condition. So we can see it is a 140 years old technology, and even cold climatic region also it is very very effective. These are different photographs taken. Okay, now if we are talking about a reinforcement inside soil, then 3,300 years old evidence are available that they use clay and reinforcement with straw. Even in our Gujarat, many villages, even in the in Bhuj also Bunga are constructed with a mud, cow dung and straw. So this combination will act as a reinforcement and it is a very good. So same technology are also used for different geotechnical structure. In 1973 Portugal, you can see because of the ice also nothing was happening. So all country having some modification. Here you can see a bag type of things are used here. Okay, bag type of things are used 1970 from France. Okay, these are the other photographs of mechanically stabilized earth slope protection for reinforcement soil. You can refer afterwards a lot of other. So each and every country has taken concept, but whatever local available material available or the plastic bits are available or some other environmental hazard that can be also used for our geotechnical structures successfully. Now this is called basal reinforcement. So I want to strengthen my road in this direction. So you can see the width of strip is more in this x direction, in y direction the strip of this width is smaller and it is also at a distance. So this is a principal direction, this is a principal direction and this is opposite direction. It's just like in RCC reinforcement we put a main steel and distribution steel. So same way here also when you design basal reinforcement, you must be very careful that in which principal direction you to put strip having larger diameter and smaller diameter. Same type of technique also we have used for India-Pakistan border for construction of road for defense tank movement. So already it is under construction. Okay, these are some on embankment, also top of embankment you can put and earth will be there. So it is to be designed very specially. These are the different, you can later on you can refer mechanical method of stabilization, chemical method of stabilization and reinforcement. This already given in many textbooks, so you can refer different techniques for ground improvement for increasing bearing capacity in other. It can be also used in earthen dam, slope stability, building foundation, even bearing capacity can be increased. One of my PhD students has worked that if I am putting a cubic style mesh below foundations, then up to 11% I can absorb earthquake energy only below foundations and my building will be protected only by cubic style mesh up to 11% energy absorption and the building can be saved. So that is proved in PhD. One of my PhD students, Divya Goyal, has worked. A number of papers also published on the same topic. Then building durability also increased because of this one. We are protecting also. There are different different materials are available. Geosynthetics, geotextile, geogrid, geonet, geomembrane, PVD, prefabricated vertical drains, geosynthetic clay liner GCL, geocell 3D confinement is possible here, geocomposite and geoother. So all details are available. Geonet and geo, we can see geo, both are just like a welding connection and fused. It is a very rigid one. While in geo membrane, other thing, it is foldable because it is very loose one. Even many times, this type of ropes are also used from the Kokon Railway project for protection of the Western Guard. We are also working for Kokon Railway, so when the train will pass, boulder will not fall down on the railway track. Here, how the mesh are created, that is shown here for the rock fall protection. So each and every design are very special. Wherever I am getting a connecting point, there the nailing. You can see the nailing are done here, and this particular steel mesh are nailed here. So whenever rock is falling, it will be trapped, and my highway will be protected. So each and every design of geonets are very special. You take photograph, and then you need to design that where I am getting a connecting point, where I am getting a strong rock for nailing purposes, and then where I can put a net very successfully. After a few years, you can see a green zone are created, and it is a very good environment friendly. This is called a trench here. This is the function of this trench. That is, you can see the Kokon railway track is there. The mesh is going here. So just for locking, so it will not slide down during earthquake or during very heavy rain. This on the slope, it will not slide down. So locking arrangement will be done. So 1 meter by 0.5 meter wide, this locking will be there, and it is filled by again a parent rock, a rough rock, and it will give me a locking arrangement. It will not, my net will not fall down on the railway track. So these are also very specially designed and erected. Geo membrane are almost impermeable type of thing, having rough structure and smooth structure depending upon my property of soil. Between it is sandy, so which type of soil I want to do protection, then accordingly you have to design and you have to select a very special type of geo membrane for your particular application. So my meaning is that there are a number of geotechnical different and environmental friendly geotechnical materials are available. For your particular type, you have to select a different material. जैसे हम लोग कॉन्क्रीट बनाते हैं तो एग्रीगेट लेते हैं, सीमेंट लेते हैं, देन वी यूज वाटर एडमिक्सर्स फाइबर्स लाइक रेनफोर्समेंट. सिमिलरली हियर आल्सो नंबर ऑफ टूल्स आर अवेलेबल इन जियोटेक्निक. फॉर अ पर्टिकुलर प्रॉब्लम यू टू यूज ऑल टूल इंटेलिजेंटली लाइक अ लैंडफिल साइट. सो फॉर इंडोनेशिया प्रोजेक्ट वी आर डिजाइनिंग दिस लैंडफिल, दिस टाइप ऑफ साइट वेरी 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 हाई इस वन. सो लीचेट कलेक्शंस विल बी देयर. सो मेम्ब्रेन विल ट्राई टू प्रोटेक्ट हियर एंड leachate will be collected somewhere here. It is taken away from environment. You have to follow all environmental rules also for canal lining, tunnel lining. Different material also we are putting. This is just one broad outline of the particular topic here. Later on we'll see. Like a canal lining, you can use geo membrane for impermeable structure. By this anchor trench, you can lock also, and only this concrete surface are there. So you can see a very effective. There is no water logging problem, and very effectively, at very high speed, my canal water can flow from this canal. Tunnel lining also for avoiding leakages. This type of lining materials are used for moisture protections. There it will try to create bullet high speed train in bullet. Two projects are already ongoing, so they also use a different technology. Like depending upon time, many times for stabilization, lime cement mortar are injected. Just to increase the bearing capacity, even for the vibration transfer from bullet train to surrounding building also, this type of infill trench lime cement mortar can be used, or open trench can be used for just for isolating bullet train. Whatever the shear velocity are generated, it will not transfer in my building, and building can be protected. So number of different techniques are shown that you can refer afterward. For noise pollution and for other for environmental protection also, this type of a plastic, this one. Geosynthetics are used. In recently my visit in Japan, I have seen that instead of two track, they are using three track. So the third track are operated when the bullet can achieve a very high speed. So the third track is also used for fixing bullet train movement with the ground properly. For reducing the flow for construction also, many time a very suppose clay is there, it is impermeable. So for consolidation, you to provide a very highly permeable drain. So it is called PVD. So these are the different type of different shapes of PVD available in market, which are inserted. So here, one of the project from Chennai, where you can see this ground is available, and by using this crane and the, by this steel strip, the PVD, the prefabricated vertical drains are created inside ground. So it will try to increase the permeability of ground, and my ground consolidation will be accelerated. And after sufficient consolidation, I can construct my railway track along on the surfaces. Geosynthetic clay liner is a very other type of thing, very intelligent material. Like this one, there are two geotextile layers are available, and there is a bentonite slurries are available. So when we are using this particular this one, and when suppose suddenly it will puncture, then automatically bentonite slurry will go in that cavity, and it will try to seal that cavity. So very this is a very intelligent material, in which because of the puncturing, automatically it will try to seal, and it will try to avoid water leakage. So one of the project in Bharuch area we have used for build up project, the geosynthetic clay liner in one particular problems. Geocell is another material which combined will be there. It is just like a, you can see confinement. Okay, what is the meaning of confinement? You know that in column, there are vertical reinforcement available, and we use a stirrup ring we are using. So the purpose of ring is, so when the vertical loading will be there, my reinforcement will not buckle, and the ring will provide as a confinement for the concrete, and we not allow the vertical movement of my column. Similarly, here also, we are putting a plastic this material. It is locked here, and the confinement. So whenever loading will be there, because of the confinement, vertical stresses, most vertical cases can be taken. You know the Poisson ratio fundamental, that if in X direction I am giving more loading in Y and Z direction, if we try to expand. If I am restricting in Y and Z direction expansion, then automatically in X direction I am getting more stress. So same fundamental we are applying in geocell, and the confinement are used. So these are already ready strips available. You can see you can just expand. And recently one of my PhD student Bhavita working, we are trying to develop a mineral bottle based geocell for construction of the road. So experimental work is already ongoing, and we have also published paper in Japan and Hong Kong conference on the same topic. Advantages and disadvantages you can refer afterwards. How it is constructed? So first of all, ground is prepared by sprinkling yellow earth and this one. Then it is open. The geocells are readily available. It is open. Two strips of geocell are stapled by these machines. Then it is expanded on the ground. Aggregates are sprinkled, and you can see after rolling, 10-ton rolling, my road is ready. So I think it is a very cost effective. You can see very quickly, very short time, you can able to construct this one, and not too worried about CBR, California bearing ratio, and other aspect for construction of the road. IIT Chennai also tried geocell and other type of waste material or storage vessels for this type of RE wall. This type of geocell construction for protection of the earthwork. These are some experimental work they have done from IIT Chennai. It is shown here. Even at a large level also, you can see a number of this type of geocells are used, stacked one by one. Even the plant can be grown points when we are doing earth filling. The plant can be grown, and very high the highway can be constructed, and the slope is also very steep, so less land required. Less land acquisition required for this technique. This is one of the container yard. You can see earlier it was constructed with a brick masonry, and heaving problem was there. So after that, the new design was given. So geotextile separator are used, and you can see a geocells are here, and the geocells are expanded, and these workers are filling in each cavity very carefully. Aggregates, you can see aggregate, and then it is ready, and up to 1, 2, and 3. You can see, suppose the one container having 20 ton weight, 20, 20, and 20, 60 ton weight, we can put only on two support on this particular geocell structure. So it is a very cost effective, very quickly even construct, as well as a very high level of capacity can be achieved in a short time. And there is environmental friendly also, no problem of other aspect. So it is also same photograph. Then, for erosion, also different materials are available depending upon the parent grain size distribution of the particle. Means what is the size of, what is the diameter of clay, what is the diameter of sand, rocks. accordingly, you have to select a different geo polymeric erosion control material. Accordingly, you have to select. So even you can do combination also. This is a larger size and this is a smaller size. Even it will also give me a lot of permeability. So it can be also used as a drainage purpose. So geo composites are available. Combinations are used. 1, 2, 3. You can see different strength and different diameter, different dimensions. So according to your designing, you have to select appropriate geo composites. These are also already we have discussed earlier. Drainage. So earlier we in retaining wall and in the highway construction we were using a boulder, or we can say the pebbles we are putting on the face of retaining wall just to drain water. But nowadays ready-made this type of available, in which the drainage is very easy, and you can see system 1, system 2, and you can just put vertical. It will not allow the movement of soil particle. At the same time, give you very, very good drainage potential. Even three-dimensional lightweight expanded polish iron, that is thermocol balls, can be used for drainage purpose also. From the cavity, it will pass three-dimensional drainage system. Geogabion can be used for construction of the road or for the protection of the seawater also. You can see L-shaped gabion. 1, 2, and 3 are locked here. Stone and this similar two L type of system we have used for India-Pakistan border. 3 meter height is achieved by this technique, and geodesic mass are there, and the local soil was used for at the top 3 meter to at 3 meter top height, the military tank movement is possible. So this technique we have used, and also it will give a lot of strength because of the confinement of the road, and as well as it will also allow the percolation of the water, rainwater and other water, and it will not disturb the problem. In Bhuj also there is a problem of salinity, but it will this is when we are using a zinc coating type of this mesh, then environmental problem and the it will not arise. This type of then again for pipeline supporting structure, gabions can be used. Geobags can be used. Plastic waste can be used, lightweight plastic waste, rubber tire, piece of rubber tire also can be used for permeability and other aspects. Okay, now when these are Swedish slip circle, so this is a slope this is a slope we are designing. Okay, if it is only earthwork, depending upon the bearing capacity and the type of soil, C and phi value, you have to design during slip circle that how it will fill and what is the safe slope for stability of this earthenwork. Earthenwork can be for road, for dam, for earthen embankment and so on. Okay, but if I am putting a reinforcement like this, vertical different spacing I'm designing, then very steep slope is possible. Very steep slope is possible. So that is the biggest advantage. And so here at a base, least length width of road is required. Less width of land is required because we are using this one, and very steep slope is possible. So you can see a different, even steppings can be used for drainage purpose. Here we can put a drainage, and stepping can be used if the slope is very high. Number of steps can be used if the slope is very high. And finally, it will be a very green type of thing, green lush, okay, environmental friendly. So in USA also, they use this type of thing. If the highway height is very high, you can see very high, 60 meter, up to 60 meter is achieved. You can see a different geodesic mesh are there, only earth and geodesic mesh. This is the name of company who has constructed this particular structure. Normally, we refer 6 degree. 6 degree tilting is one of the base one, but you can design as per your requirement. So these are small stone blocks, and this fascia, the pressure of the earth will be there, surcharge pressure will be there, and here we are putting a geodesic mesh, which will, because of the friction, will not allow the movement of block outside. And when the earthquake will be there, this block will try to come out. At the same time, this mesh will try to push inside, and it is a self-balancing mechanism. So very specifically designs are required, but at the same time, it is also very cost-effective. As compared to RCC, it is very cost-effective, RCC retaining wall. In this type of structure, there are different failure modes are there. Pull-out, tensile, local, sliding, overturning, bearing capacity failure, or the sliding. So all the 7 possibility you have to check before designing this highway abutment or other structure. Geo polypropylene geodesic, these are the different materials available. Geo grid, already we have explained having different direction. The strengths are different. In this direction, strengths are higher. In other directions, strengths are lower. Just like a distribution and mesh tilt, it can be manufactured in a geo grid form or solid pattern. It can be tested for different ASTM standards are available. ASTM 6637. Different standards are available that how it will creep and shrinkage, other property, permeability, creep testing. So all standards are available. See, plastic, we cannot use ordinary plastic. But you do, when you design for our bridge and highway or for the airport structure, very specific creep requirement are to you to mention, and everything to be mentioned very specifically in tender, and accordingly you to construct your structure. Different comparison of different materials are shown from tensile strength point of view. Durability aspects are shown. These also we have discussed already, being back form, retaining wall, cost comparison is shown. Traditional fabric wood, wood form, wire basket type, we'll see later on, segmental block type of thing. So here also a basket type of thing. And even many times the clothes are directly taken. These are the just a temporary wooden pack. So you put your this baggage like this, and you fill up soil, lock here properly, again compact properly with a roller. Again, take a second level, remove this wooden block, and so on. So in this way, you can able to construct this type of mountain type of structure for highway. Even cold climatic region also, it will work very efficiently. So India, it is not too much popular, but in other country, it is very popular. Even you can see a temporary here, temporary wooden pack, and these plastic sheets are wrapped here. It is locked here properly. Again, it is wrapped, and the highway is constructed. Okay, these are different materials. Material difference are there. Depending upon your type of soil, you can select different materials. These are wire, welded wire basket also using some of the company. It is a truss mechanism. Vertical truss are there and horizontal truss are there. It is locked with a 45 degree pin element. You can see 45 degree pin element. And it is kept here. So you can see that this person is standing. The wire baskets are there. Then the earth filling will be there. And again, the locking of the pin will be there. Even we can grow plant in whatever this stepping are there, we can able to grow plant also. And you can see a very high, as you can, according to human scale, you can imagine what is the height of this particular structure. So each country having a different material and different capability, different company having different confidence also available. So confidence of the company or the confidence of contractor also equally important as compared to designer here. Vegetable wall. So here you can see the stepping are there. You can see here. One wire mesh, second wire mesh having some step here. Gaps are available. We are putting here seeded top soil. We are putting soil here with the seeding. So after few days when the rain will there, so here you can see a grass or the growth of plant is available. So green record can be achieved. So it is a very environmental friendly material. And even this type of double layer can be used if the height is more, one layer and second layer. So in cold climatic region also, this type of extra safety measures are required for the thermal, because in cold climatic region, temperature may be minus 20 degree and high temperature may be plus 30 degree. So you may go for a double protection system also. So this also from the London, UK. So here in this particular picture, these are RE wall, retaining wall, and here we are putting drainage filter media. So when the rainwater will be there, it will percolate here, and from this pipe it will be taken out, prefabricated, it will be taken out and it will be taken away. So when we are controlling the pore water pressure in the soil, it will avoid the failure of this particular thing. If I am not putting, even in RCC also we are putting here wipe hole, different at 1 meter, 1.5 meter distance, we put a wipe hole just to decrease the pore water pressure. Otherwise, pore water pressure will be very high. It may try to crack even RCC wall also. So here, drainage media is most important. And if I am putting this type of geotextile based drainage media, then definitely it will work and also very cost effective. Even a small block can be a retaining wall, can be reinforced retaining wall can be created. You can see a mesh is there. This different blocks are placed, interlocking block are placed. But here, main thing that if the contractor is not efficient, some error will be there. Then when minor tremor of earthquake will be there, very heavy rain will be there, or very heavy vehicle will pass from the road, then suddenly failure will be occurring. So these are three different failure. You can see the rolling direction. Directions of the materials are not kept in the principal direction, and the total failure was there. So you must be very careful when you construct. A lot of care required in construction, because here factor of safety also. The designing is very economical. At the same time, you have to take an appropriate factor of safety in depending upon the contractor capacity. Even installation is not proper, then you can see the settlement is occurred. It is a settlement of a road. Road is constructed, but there is a settlement issue, or maybe the RE wall is tilted and a crack was formed. Total failure, incorrect enforcement, total failure. So recently we come across one project in Kota where, because of the train vibration, the RE wall was buckled outside on the railway track side, and now almost it is not possible to repair. So we have to go for reconstruction, or we have to create another RCC retaining wall just to support all failed gabion or RE wall type of structure. So installation issue is also there. So lot of care are required during construction. Then these are also failure because of the improper spacing of the in vertical layer. Even the erosion protections also possible using this one. See, erosion protection is one of the major issue in India, as the tide height are increasing slowly. These are also Manitoba in Canada. The construction of bridge is there, and baskets are used. We can see, and the stones are kept here. Stone are kept here. Okay, these are the detailed diagrams are shown here. We can put a load also here. We can put a load also here. Here also. In construction of bridge, even for the railway track also, this type of this Mira grid, geode grid. So these are the name of company who manufacture is erected. Please remember that when we support here this highway girder or this train girder, please remember that you have to do piling, and then you have to support. Don't try to put directly on this earthen structure. It is not so much capable. So in proof checking, when we get proof checking, we are checking that whether they have provided here piling work for supporting, or they have transferred all the girder load on this type of earthen structure. It is not so much capable. So you must be very careful in designing. You must provide a sufficient load transfer mechanism up to deep soil. These also from USA, a step type of things are used. Plantations are there, very beautiful. It is shown here. Gardening are there, stepping are there. At the same time, bridge structure. So when we pass, you can see a very beautiful landscaping here. At the same time, it is cheaper and environmental friendly thing. So same thing we want to now do in India also. Airport access road, Mussoorie. Here you can see now very clearly the bridge load, the span is less, but it is not transferred here. It is transferred on the steel. It is transferred on the steel and this pier cap. It is also from California. Here, inverted 45 degree wooden strips are used. You can see inverted 45 degree. Here, 45 degrees, this wooden strips are there, and the pegging of the wooden strips are used. Okay, and then earth filling are there. So these are specifically because there, this wood are very cheaply available. So we have discussed, and the green field, green now plants are coming out from, okay, these are also from other country. Then here also same structure are observed. Even at curvature also it is possible, because at curvature centrifugal force of vehicle will also transfer, and slightly more factor of safety required when the curvature of the highway is there. And support abutment wall here. So not only in bridge, but here in designing also, you have to take extra surcharge because of the centrifugal force acting. These are the world tallest 242 feet high slope. These are end of a runway are designed. Same type of structure, even in 73 meter, even by Mecca Ferry company had designed. in India, in Sikkim area. So end of the runway are also protected by this type of structure that is also tallest in India. So to artificial mountain, you can see this is like a 242 feet high artificial mountain. Okay, if you will consider 10 feet height of the floor height, it is just like a 24 story building. Was 242 feet height means 24 story building. The height of structure is 24 story building. Again, these are the different shapes and already discussed geotextile, geoglid, geocell, GCL. Already we have discussed geonet, geocomposite, geopipe, GCL. So all these tools we have to combine for your problem. Depending upon your consulting problem, you have to combine and then you have to do work. Geo knitted, non-woven, woven. The function of this one is separation, reinforcement, drainage, filter, and barrier. So it is from the textbook. At the undergraduate level, you learn these are the function of geotextile and other things. Okay, now I will discuss you my student work. So Dr. Jigisha Vashi, she was my PhD student, and we are trying to develop just 1 minute. Okay, different material. So whatever local soils are available. So for alluvial construction, normally we put a gravel and other type of material. But whatever local is soil available. By adding fly ash, by special composition, we are trying to develop a material which can be used for construction of the bridge abutment. So here, whatever soils are local soil are available, we are mixing and doing a triaxial testing and a different type of testing here. We are also putting a different geotextile layer here. You can see the in geocell. When we put a tin triaxial machine, we put a geocell here. This material, we are observing what the filter pattern and other thing. And it was implemented in one of the projects, and the wastage was surrounding wastage was used for construction. So this is one of the field applications. At an analytical level also, we have tried that what are the different inclination is possible, embankment, which slope, vertical, depending upon different spacing, different angle, different weight we are putting here, it is possible to design. So using a geo different type of geotextile software designing, we later will see it was designed. These are the variable we have taken, different property of PET 500, PET 100. These are the different capacity of the geotextile. We are using a different end conditions also shown here. Even shaping is also possible. So GE05 finite element software was used here for analysis for PhD work. So here shaping was done. Our papers are also available in journal, international journal. You can refer, or it is available in my departmental library. You can refer, no problem. So these are how it will look in software. These are the finite element mesh in finite element mesh of the soil is shown. Even you can, if the width of road is smaller, it is a single lane road, then you can go through and through also. Not only on the surface, but you can take from one end to other end directly. So it is also very cost effective. Through and through is also possible. These are the Swedish field circle theory, how it will fail. So there are thousands of possibility by which my slope will fail. But when we provide the appropriate level geotextile, then the steep slope is possible. So it is factor of safety you can work out, and it can be designed very efficiently on the software. Special software are available. These are the contour of the stresses are shown here, how when the load surcharge will be there, how even suppose earthquake we are applying, then how pressure is built up inside soil, that is also possible to predict by the software. Then polymer mat, grass polymer mat, pre-cultivated grass, seeding, ready-made seedings are also available. Stone pitching, stone pitching is also there. So in Japan, we have seen that they are using not only stone pitching, but these all grid are RCC grid they are using. And then combination of stone pitching and geotextile mesh are used. Gabion facing can be possible. Gabion facing with geotextile different applications is also a very high level, 8 meter high, only embankment is there. And here you can see a 20% clay field and 80% fly ash. So this is an innovation done by my PhD student Jigisha Vashi. So you can see a mixture of this particular is sufficient enough to because of scarcity of sand and other aspect. Okay, we can go for a whatever environmental wastage material is there, that can be used for this type of structure. The techniques are used here. Fiber-reinforced soil. Okay, now here, these are the ready-made available. Rackron 3 is Reliance company is manufacturing this. Different fibers are available in market, 6 millimeter, 12 millimeter, and 18 mm is recently invented. Actually, these fiber are used for concrete, RCCP pavement quality concrete. With this fiber, we can, without reinforcement, we can construct roads. So in Surat, many roads are constructed. But here, we have tried same material in soil. So in soil, manually it was mixed. It was mixed, and now we have tested. Basically, it is this particular fiber having a triangle shape and 40 micron is size. These are length 6 millimeter, 12 and 18 mm are the length of fiber, but the cross section is 40 micron triangle shape. Okay, so because of the triangle shape, it will lock properly even in cement particle in concrete as well as in our earth also very properly. So we are trying to develop this material just like when we grow tree, then the root system will hold soil. Similarly, here artificially we are inserting fibers in clay and trying to develop a earthquake or the other resistance structure and increasing bearing capacity. Even triaxial testing also, you can see the fiber mixed soil, it take more load, graphs are plotted. Is ordinary 0% means ordinary dry OMC OMDD, maximum dry density. In compaction testing, maximum dry density and OMC, optimum moisture content. These are the ordinary graph, and I'm adding fiber 1.52 fiber, and you can see it is shifted and it is giving a good result. So these are different material we are using. CPR can be improved by 600%. That is one of the fantastic result. So the meaning is, if I am constructing highway and I am using this fiber for construction of the road, then I can construct 10% higher road at the same cost, because whatever earthwork, the compaction, and what is the cost of compaction, what is the yellow earth required. Here the layer, suppose in highway construction, 1 meter yellow earth is required. Then if I am adding this fiber, then instead of 1 meter, only 500 mm or 600 mm earthwork is sufficient with fiber. So I am reducing the earthwork cost. In the same cost, I can construct 10 to 11% higher length of highway. So CPR improvement was very high. And this is done by one of my PhD student, Kalpana Maheshwari, and the same paper was presented in Egyptian conference, and it was appreciated. Even for the building also in footing, if we are adding the layer of the soil, then it can be useful. So this is the footing is here, polyester fiber 0.25, different fiber length and size are erected at a different depth. Means width of footing by B/8, B/4, B/2 and B are shown here. So mixing of the soil, the properly it is compacted with minor hammering. Then the testing was done here by dial gauge. The different settlement observations was taken. This is my student Pranav Maheshwari, and in experimentally the by jack the loadings are applied. The movement of soil are also recorded with dial gauges. And the graphs are plotted, load versus settlement. You can later on you can refer different length of fiber, different depth, and it is giving a very fantastic result. Just broadly, I can say that very fantastic result. So even bearing capacity low, you can improve bearing capacity below soil also for the multi-story building also it can be used. So model testing was done here. Actual footing, large earlier was a small size footing. Now the big size footing was tested. Big size full scale testing was done in laboratory. You can see the mixing of the fiber, proper gradation was done, and compaction was done, and then the plate flotation was conducted. Okay, now other student on the same concept, other student has worked for my MTech program, Miss Uma. Now what we have done, these are from the Kargil. You know, in Kargil what happening in Ladakh and Kargil area, that when the this part of the military tank movement or was the other aspect, this particular load, you can see when there is a crack in the road, so water will go inside. When the water is converted at minus 50 degree in ice, it will expand volumetrically 2.5 times. So when it will expand, it will crack the road. Okay, now so you can see the tank, this different military equipment movement and other thing. So what happening, so we have collected soil sample from the Ladakh and the Kargil area and try to add fiber and given in laboratory as per IS 4332, minus 24 degree, minus 10 degree centigrade temperature and thawing +25 degree centigrade during sunlight. So -10 degree is possible by our ordinary freeze and +25 degree just by sunlight. So the repeated cycle was given 0, 1, 2, 3 cycle, and we got fantastic result. And even up to 10 cycle also, the almost the compressibility of the soil and other aspects are satisfied. So this is one of the very innovative work. So fiber can be even used with mixing by soil. Even it can be used in very high altitude mountain road or where there is a problem of temperature in Siberia or even in the northeast or in the green field. So this work was very appreciated, and later on the Australian team has taken up this work for further research work. So this is one of the very innovative work we have done. Application of fiber in post clay soil for canal. This is also from the same that student Kalpana Maheshwari. So one of the subsidiary minor canal work of for water distribution was there, and we have tried here. So this is earthwork for constructing canal. So we have tried in Swiss circle theory. We have calculated what is the factor of safety and other aspect for ordinary canal. But now if I am reading here the fiber reinforced soil having a particular depth, then at a very steep slope it is possible. This is Narmada branch canal in South Gujarat, one of the South Gujarat problem. You can see the 350 millimeter fiber reinforced soil lining was done here. Okay, even concrete also lining was done at a very steep slope is possible, and less earthwork is required. Basically less earthwork is required, compaction is required, so it is also very cost effective. So on experimental ground, one of the canal was erected, main canal and distributor here, more with 500 millimeter reinforced soil lining was done. Another canal, minor canal. So even if we will add fiber using the software, we can able to calculate a very good factor of safety against sliding. So Swedish field curve, you can refer later on in how the stress are visible in computer software that is shown here on different software. For mixing also, our plowing type of farmers are using this type of a tool for farming. So same type of tool even we can use earth and fiber mixing. We can use and using Praxis 3D, it is possible to calculate how the stresses are transferred and what are the stress contour. I am putting my surcharge loading here, and at different layer, subgrade, of course, base core. This is for the road or for the other work. You can calculate exactly the stress contour and other thing in both direction, in a vertical direction, in a x direction and y direction. So these are the software output. The NCIS and Praxis software results are compared. Okay, these are the different direction loading. So whenever there is a braking load, particularly when the braking load are inclined, it is not vertical. So when the braking load will be there, or suppose my vehicle is passing and suddenly it will accelerate its gear. So then also inclined loadings are generated on the earthwork. So these are also from Praxis 2D on reinforcement. Okay, now the other student, Yogendra Tandel, we have tried stone column. These are one of the example in Taj Mahal also. In 1653, this type of technology was adopted. If the soil is not proper, then the building may fail. See, the building is intact. Structural engineering point of view, building having no problem. You can see less crack, good elevation, architecturally good elevation. But here, the foundation is separated or overtoppled, totally overtoppling. We don't know the reason. Maybe possible that there is a possibility of liquefaction of soil or some differential soil parameter. Even on the left side and right side, my soil having different property. This is on the, you know, the Italian pizza, the Leaning Tower of Pisa. Okay, the bearing capacity on left side is good, right side was less, and that's why it was tilting. And it is a world famous structure. So actually, it is a failure of geotechnical engineer basically, because he has taken the same type of soil throughout from left end to right end of rough foundation. But actually, it is at the edge of two junction of soil, and that's why it is Leaning Tower of Pisa. Okay. And it is attracting wild tourists. Actually, it is a failure of engineering basically, but everybody attracted. But here, you can imagine what happened to the persons living in this building. Okay. Now, how the stone? Okay, for stability of soil, we can construct a stone column. So you can drill this hole. You can add here stone, and it can be rammed. It can be pushed inside ground. So my diameter will increase, and because of the locking of the stone inside ground. It is a stone column pile, and the upper soil having a very good bearing capacity. So the stone column mechanism we have also implemented in Kandla project and other aspects. The also one of the building below rock foundation, this was done it is very near to seashore. So different technology depending upon type of your problem, you can select dynamic compaction, also grouting. Even suppose there is a cavity available, you can go for cement grouting, injection grouting for sealing this cavity, and then you can even the circular grouting. This gravity cavity, it is not stone column, it is a grouting in a circular pattern. So it will freeze, it will create, try to create inside in situ pipe with the natural sand is available, and grouting will mix up and try to create a vertical column. So these are the different mixing, different mechanism available. Stone column, you can refer different technology. So here also different technology are shown for construction of the airport island. You can see different layers of soil, it will improve, and then you can construct a runway and other aspect. So what is the fundamental? So here you can see this is a natural soil. Now I am removing natural earth. Now I am adding stone, and now I am pushing. So when I am pushing, the bulging will be took place. When it will bulge, it will lock, and definitely when it will lock, it will not allow the further movement of the rock below, and it will give me more vertical pressure according to fundamental of Poisson ratio. So little pressure will increase, and it will give me more pressure. This is the fundamental of a stone column. Now you can encase in geotextile encased stone column also. Geotextile encased stone column also is possible. So here one of the field example is taken from the research paper. So these are laboratory also we have done lot of work. Encased stone column, geotextile and stone, and it is then locked. And geotextile encased stone column, these are the different steps. Even these are one of the example taken from this particular airport, you can refer afterwards. Displacement method can be used, means earth is displaced. You can see the size as compared to human being, what is the size of the diameter of this one. You can displace, and then you can drill hole, and then you can add other material. So in laboratory also it is possible to test. So we have done that. So this is a ordinary soil, we have drill hole, this is a geotextile is inserted, and then using a special tool, we have poured a special tool with a very specific density, we have poured our stone, and then the load are applied on the stone column, and the different using alveolity, what is the displacement of soil, and other aspect are studied. This work, even this can be, of course, in PhD work, that Yogendra Tandel has not worked. But even for the sloping ground also you want to stabilize, the stone column can be inserted in sloping ground and can be used for the nailing purpose. So one of the problem in the bullet train, we have proposed this type of technology to create a steep slope and the safe movement of bullet train. So your finite element method can be used for analytically also, it is possible to calculate what are the stress generated in the stone column. These are the actual stone column bulging, it was removed. These are the experimental result, analytical results, comparisons, and these are the stress contour on the software when we apply loading, where the stresses are generated. So upper layer, when we apply loading naturally, you can see in upper layer my stresses are very high as compared to lower level. Bulging is also very high. So how it is here combination of four pile are used, four stone column pile are combined together. 1, 2, 4 holes are there, and the from this funnel aggregates are poured. Aggregate having a very small size because we have to scale down model as compared to the field problem. So scaling down was done, and then the reading was taken. So PhD degree already awarded, Yogendra Tandel. So these are experimental work, analytical work, analytical results are shown. Even you can refer his paper in International Journal paper along with me. Yeah, here these are the deformed shape after the bulging, the earth was removed and it was washed, and just to see what is the shape and other aspect that can be seen here. After experiment is over, it was removed and seen that how it was bulged. These are the experimental work. These are some field examples, right? Okay, now here also it was used. You can see the encasement was done, experimental work was done, experimental and the very heavy loading was done. Now another student, Nihal Dalal, PhD work. What is the problem? This is Nihal Dalal, Dr. Nihal Dalal, now staying in Baroda. What is the problem? That year, you can see that these are garbage land actually. So our Surat Municipal Corporation is throwing all the waste in the in Khajod waste site. Yes, these are Khajod waste site. Okay. Now we are trying to strengthen soil by special mechanism, and we want to construct ground plus three-story housing for the urban poor. So basically, we want to determine what is the correlation between the natural soil and what is the property of this garbage. We want to correlate, and for that, this type of special for in situ measurement of water table and other thing, this detector and the source was used for. It is transmitting wave are transmitted from year to year, and it will give me nucleic density meter. It will give me different property of soil. These are measurement was done on site. This one it was designed in laboratory, and the plate flow test was conducted. So we have given a different arrangement, and sees that my student. So in this Khajod waste site, the four different technique was adopted for designing foundation, and then the load are given. Then the loads are given. Actual loads are given like this. GI mattresses are used, having a GI mattress aggregate layer. It is specially designed in laboratory. By calculation, it was designed and then erected for the plate flow test. Then even in laboratory, the equivalent soil was determined because the garbage having some property and our soil having some property. Equivalent soil was determined, and then in the laboratory also triaxial and all the testing work was done. What is the capacity? How failure pattern will be there? Then analytical modeling was done using the SAP software. So this is a garbage soil finite element modeling. These are my steel plate or where I am putting my load, and the stress contour can be calculated. So here different type of geotextile mesh are erected, then the loads are applied. These are footing and the different layers and how it will buckle soil model with foundation. So in SAP software you can structure a soil work can be modeling is possible. Because of shortage of time I am not discussing, but normally for tall building we are using a pile up type of system. Graft and pile combined are used. So slightly I will increase my speed. Stress is developed below soil. You can see how it will look. And then earthquake loading, El Centro and Kobe earthquake was applied on the computer model. You can see a garbage soil foundations, garbage soil. Then treatment was given, isolated footing was erected, RCC column was erected, and the earthquake loading was given on computer software just to simulate what is the effect in SAP 14 software, and the reading was taken. So these are the deformation of soil during earthquake and everything you can defer. The other important aspect is soil structure interaction. So when you want to construct a tall building, so above 80 meter, above 85 meter, compulsory you to go for soil structural interaction, in which soil and structure modeling combine you to take. Normally, software we consider fixed base and the structure we design. But normally, now for tall building, compulsory you to go for soil structure interaction. We have also given recently training to Reliance employee, Bombay. So what is soil structural interaction? So these are the diagram. So when the earthquake shock will go inside pile or other thing from soil. So soil will also behave differently. My pile will also differently. My pile can be also differently, and superstructure will behave differently. So you to go for the combined movement of structure and soil. That is called soil structure interaction. These are the different models. Only foundation with pile, and the column taken away from pile taken away. Then so all three behavior are different in the soil structure interaction. That the analytical modeling for computer software also shown here. You can use D'Alembert principle. Later on you can refer. So in machine foundation, my vibration are transferring from machine to soil. In this particular seismic excitation, vibration are transferring from soil to structure. So both are different, but fundamentals can be used are interconnected. In Winkler approach, the rock footing, we use a spring modeling. We use a spring modeling. So when we apply loading, the Winkler spring will deflect equally and accordingly. You can design rock foundation. So it will, if the loading is higher, my spring will compress more. Here it is shown here. If the loading is higher, my spring will compress more. If more vertical pressure will be there, so accordingly we can design my rock foundation. It is cheaper. Even below pile cap also it can be possible. So these are some. Okay, what are the spring are required? So vertical, horizontal, rocking, all the spring having different property. That is different spring depending upon type of soil you to calculate. And this appropriate spring you to add apply on the surface of pile and rock foundation. So these are the correlations between density and other soil property. So you to accept this is a structure foundations. and pile. So you can see a different pile around surrounding pile also, at the base of pile also, and the appropriate stiffness of ring are applied, and the soil property are inserted for computer software. These are just approximate value are shown, hard, medium, and soft soil, shear modulus, elasticity modulus, poison ratio. That these are value useful for input of the software thing. These are the different property of the soil are shown, damping property and other things are shown. Soil flexibility here also, the schema 356 and is also given some concept, upper bound and lower bound. You can refer for theoretical study. Spring constant values are given. So how the why pile is required for low load, even you can go for directly foundations, but if the strong rocks are below, then by pile you have to transfer load from this layer to this layer, end bearing pile or this one. What is the pile draft? In pile draft, my raft and pile both will take load. So when we talk about a tall building like a Burj Dubai or even World One Tower of Bombay, 442 meter high, a pile draft foundation was used for tall building. Here not shown, but we have also worked for that. My Shukla has done a lot of work on this topic. Then even the loading is also possible. We have to, when the problem is very complicated, then even the horizontal loading on pile is also required. So for one of the bridge structure in Surat, the pile load testing was also done for lateral load stability. These are the spring estimation, damping property. Of course, it is for the dynamic vibration problem. Richard and Lesmert, that is for machine foundation problem, not for the static vibration problem. For pile draft foundation philosophy are shown here, that you can refer, that pile draft is the most efficient solution. But what is the percentage of pile and what is the percentage of raft has taken load, that is to be calculated analytically. Plate load tests are shown here, just for your references. So whenever we construct a bridge load test, bridge designing, you have to go for plate load test, vertical as well as horizontal. So these are horizontal plate load tests. The rods are, when we apply horizontal loading, what is the displacement of the pile in horizontal direction are measured. During earthquake, on pile, my horizontal thrust are there. During earthquake, pile are subjected to horizontal loading, that is shown here, and how it will buckle, what are the different failure modes of pile, that is shown here during seismic loading. These are the case study. The bridge was collapsed because of the failure of pile. One of the case studies shown here. If it will buckle, it will buckle from here and here. You can see my pressure distribution below pile will change, and that's why it will try to tilt and it will collapse bridge. So designing of pile is very, very important in designing particular bridge structure in a near field earthquake zone particularly. So this is from the JRA, Japanese Road Association of India. So earthquake loading of pile can be possible by different software, plus Plexus. These are the different software. Even SAP also it is possible. Settlement of pile also can be determined by equations. These are shown. How the loads are transferred, that is shown. Settlement you can calculate. Load sharing mechanism for pile raft. Raft will also contribute load. Pile will also contribute load. 54 pile will also contribute load. That you can refer later on. Machine foundations having four different type: block type, box type, wall type, and frame type. Frame type are used in which my book is published. Frame type are used when we want to generate electricity. So because 3000 to 6000 RPM revolutions are required of machine, then only we can produce electricity. So these are the actual turbine, very huge. So here in this frame type, what happening, that just to control permissible amplitude of vibration, we have to take a springing action of column. So because of the machine vibration, my column will sway here and there by springing action. At drop level, vibration will be zero, and it will be very cost. So this is a frame type is compulsory required for any power generation project. So these are the photograph from Saudi Arabia, steam turbine generator for electricity production. One of my student, PhD student, completed Sungyan Tripathi. Number of ACI papers are available, in which we have used a special type of Barrett foundation. What is the Barrett? My column and pile are in the same line. It is called Barrett. So we have conducted experimental work in my photograph, my student photograph, and the turbines are working here at the top one. The experimental work is shown on shake table. Experimental work is number of soil layer are taken. Is a turbine is kept here, and on the shake table vibration was given here, and vibrations are measured. This is analytical model of the same thing. Even for tall chimney also it is required, guide chimney, ordinary chimney. So if we will, without soil structure interaction, I will design wrap foundation for chimney, and we soil structure interaction having a, the results are totally different. So we cannot neglect soil. Okay, so here different tall chimneys are shown, the time period are shown here. If I'm changing the shear velocity measure, velocity, then analytical modeling is done. So it will give me insertion of this different shear wave and giving different time period. So soil structure interaction is also required for tall chimney. Now this is another work done by Pooja Rao under an ongoing, in which the bullet train vibrations, we are trying to transfer, how it will transfer and how the soil will behave. For that, this particular equipment elimination was done, and the patent was applied for patenting. Even in laboratory, we can measure what, how by soil, bullet train vibration will transfer in soil. So this already, this equipment we have applied for the patent and waiting for the patent by Pooja Rao. Another work in which a tall wind turbine. These are monopole tower and the hybrid wind tower. Here wind turbine will rotate on the shake table. So earthquake also we can apply. How it will behave? So these are the different temperatures, and the earthquake shocks are given and measured. So here we can go for pile foundation and wrap foundation. Of course, here the fixed base is shown, but actually in analytical modeling, this student, my Hemal Shah, my student has also work, and we have tried to develop a soil structural interaction modeling for wind chimney also. And in Gujarat, 120 meter tallest wind chimney in Rajkot we have erected for Suzlon industry. So then this problem was converted into PhD topic, and I think this is the last topic, and thank you for personal listening, and you are most welcome for any questioning. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Hello.
Thank you, sir, for your wonderful session. So now we have 5 to 6 questions from the participant. First question,
yeah,
is what is life span for such a materials which you have discussed in your slides?
Yeah, it is a life span. Whatever these material are, plastic basically, plastic and other. So we can definitely take 7500 years, no problem. So each company is specifying what is the life span. Okay, you know, plastic will not decompose. Okay. If I am using jute, in Kerala, they are, here it was not discussed, but in Kerala, they are also using jute fiber. So jute are natural fiber that can be decomposed. But normally they use jute fiber with seeding also. So after, suppose 10 years, my jute fiber will decompose. In meanwhile, my whatever the seeds are there, it will grow, it will convert into plant, and it will try to hold soil efficiently for canal lining work. So in jute only the problem of decomposition or the termite problem will be there. Otherwise in plastic there is no question of decomposition, it will be in inherent material. Even in heavy rainfall or even any problem, even I have discussed problem of that India Pakistan border, we have used zinc coated strip. Okay, zinc coated strip we have used. So definitely even salty environment like a Pakistan border, it is not creating any problem, and successfully the road was constructed for 5.5 kilometers. Any other question?
For making road, it's good to use geotechnical material instead of quarry, spoil or other such materials?
No, I can't understand your question because it's a very vast subject.
For making road, it's good to use geotechnical material instead of quarry, spoil or other such material?
No, it is depending upon the severity of problem. If the nearby, always we, suppose here, you of course I am not involved, but one of my faculty member has used a copper waste and other material for construction of road from Surat to Olpad. 20-30 kilometer patch are used with the copper and slag and other material. It is a waste product of nearby site. Okay, so what is the waste product material are there, and what effectively you want to utilize, depending upon that only you have to select material. Correct. It is always aisa nahi ke bhai aapko use hi karna. If the bearing capacity is very low, there are a lot of other problems are there, then definitely you can switch over to this material and you can design. Okay, many times it can be for maintenance purpose. Okay, aapka highway aapne bana diya hai, aapka highway toot gaya hai. Okay, and now you don't want to take any risk. So again, you will not use earth, but you will go for a very special material, and definitely the repairing of highway is possible. and definitely it will last for next 25 years without any problem. Next question.
How safe is to make retaining wall with geotech material on site near river bank?
It can be used, no problem. It can be used. Okay, it can be slightly the inclination. I cannot do 6 degree tilting. We have to go for slightly more, tilting. Means you 45 degree or 60 degree like that only you can use. Already it was for the even geo this gabion structure near. If you are in Surat near Sita Rock, we have designed. We have designed a gabion structure already on the side of bank of river Tapti. About 800 meter are used with a gabion only. You can see and you can go there. No problem. It is already implemented. It's nothing new. Even for that Banvi project also, we have used successfully gabion and geostyle for 92 feet height water flow in Tapti Basin, Tapti River. And again, in Banvi problem is very critical because just 600 meter away there is a dam available. So when the dam will surcharge water in Tapti River, the flow velocity is nearly 6 to 7 meter per second, and that is I think one of the tallest earthen work embankment protection in Gujarat, because a lot of R&B road and building irrigation department persons are calling us, and for Rameswaram temple project it was successfully used, and now they are visiting R&B circle also visiting this particular site. That how you have done this work. Of course we have also used piling for when the very heavy 6 to 7 meter per second water flow is there. So we have also used combination of pile and gabion and geotextile. Three system we have used and it was successfully done. And it is, I think, one of the finest project in Gujarat as far as the embankment protection is concerned on the river bank. That you can refer. If you want more material, I will give you. Hello, next question.
Which techniques are used for construction of palm islands?
Palm island, I think, I am not sure, I am not aware, but I think it is a dredging of sand. Ponding of sand was done, I am not sure, but ponding of sand was done. Similar technology also used in India, near Hajira for acquiring Reliance and Hajira build. They have used a mud pumping from the deep portion, and then by ponding technique, they have done all the, first of all, embankment ka wo karte hai, then that sludge is pumped in that one. So after evaporation of the or the percolation of water, the sludge will be settled down and slowly the height will increase. So I think the land acquired in Hajira are done by this technique in India. But I am not aware because I was not part of that particular topic. But techniques are available. Even on YouTube also you will find. So you will see the on the National Geography, or even you will find on YouTube. You just write down the a video for construction of the palm island, then definitely you will get, because it is a world famous technique and a lot of videos are available, but I am not aware about this part. Many times trapoids also used, trapoid, gabion, in the one of the Selbath project, trapoid are also used, and trapoid are used near the bank of sea for protection, and then gabion was erected. So combinations can be used for depending upon type of problem. Tidal height fluctuation is more important. If my tidal height fluctuation is 5 meter, 3 meter, then definitely very special technique are useful. But if it is very low, 1 meter height fluctuation of tide, depending upon your topography and geographical location, then definitely the techniques are different. So whenever some sea protection work will be there, we are asking what is the fluctuation of water table. So not water table, sorry. The high tide and low tide level, what is the fluctuation? And then you have to decide what is the severity of problem and which technique is to be adopted. Okay. So for the Dahej also, they have contacted us, but we have demanded that please give us data, what is the fluctuation of seawater, but they have not still given. Then you have to decide technique, which technique you have to use for protection. Next one.
What about the construction cost using geotechnics when compared to traditional methods? Will it to be high?
Miss water, what type of problem? Basically, these all are bhai dawa chhe Gujarati mein apne kahiye na manas sa it is, or suppose you are giving to healthy person, it is a tonic. Suppose you are giving vitamins to healthy person, it is a tonic. But if you are giving this vitamins to ill people, it is a medicine. Okay, it is same thing here also in engineering, geotechnical engineering. Okay, आप ये सपोज आपका स्ट्रक्चर बहुत अच्छा है एंड यू आर यूजिंग देन इट इज गिविंग यू मोर स्ट्रेंथ टू सॉइल एंड इट विल इम्प्रूव द परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ योर स्ट्रक्चर परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ योर बिल्डिंग बट मेनी टाइम सपोज यू आर डिजाइनिंग रोड ऑन सैंड ड्यून्स और प्रॉब्लमेटिक सॉइल लिक्विफाइबल सॉइल स्लज और मड देन इट इज अ मेडिसिन विदाउट दिस नॉट पॉसिबल टू कंस्ट्रक्ट रेलवे ट्रैक बुलेट ट्रैक और बुलेट ट्रेन और बुलेट ट्रेन ट्रैक और वी कैन से द हाईवे स्टेट हाईवे सो आपका प्रॉब्लम के हिसाब से आपको नक्की करने का है बराबर ना हेलो नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन
व्हाट अबाउट द इन रिसेंट टाइम्स वी हैव सीन स्पेशली इन सूरत दैट फॉर मोस्ट ऑफ द बिग प्रोजेक्ट्स इट वाज एडवाइज्ड टू प्रोवाइड डायाफ्राम वॉल्स ऑल्सो वी हैव सीन फेलियर ऑफ डायाफ्राम वॉल ड्यू टू द लैक ऑफ एंकरिंग व्हेन हाइट ऑफ डायाफ्राम वॉल एक्सीड्स द सर्टन हाइट As it is a permanent structure, is it possible to provide alternative solution like sheet piling where suitable, which will eventually reduce the material and the speed of the construction as it takes less time at the construction site?
Very intelligent and very good question. I must appreciate this question. Okay, let me start from because this is one of the very current problem and just 15 days back on 11th I have a meeting with our Surat Municipal Commissioner regarding same aspect because I am a reviewer for the tall building in Surat area so we have sanctioned five projects having more than 70 meter height with my signature I have already submitted and presented all the papers to our Surat Municipal Commissioner so at the same time also Commissioner asked me whatever question was asked by this guy regarding diaphragm wall. Okay, let me start that before 2 years in Surat for construction of basement, underground basement, minus two floor, minus three floor, eight basements was constructed, out of which I think seven basement diaphragm wall was collapsed. But collapsed. One of the investigation was given to SMNLD. I was along with my other professor, Jignesh Pai Patel. We have investigated that site for one of the builder in the Vesu area. The problem was there in designing, first of all, let me give you very clearly, that actually in diaphragm wall, they have given only one anchor pile for anchoring, inclined anchoring pile for earth retaining structure. Okay. But if theoretically, because the investigation was given to us, so we have calculated on the computer software. And we have seen that instead of one, two anchoring pile are required. One is at bottom and one is at top. Okay. And the other aspect that the designer has not considered saturated soil. They have considered dry soil. These two mistakes was there in designing. And naturally, the same other seven project, of course, they have not contacted us, but the same designer has designed. So the logic is very simple that instead of two anchoring pile, they have given only one anchoring pile in vertical direction, number one. And number two, designer has not considered saturated condition of soil. So what I mean to say that if you want to put a diaphragm wall, then designing is very, very important. Okay. Here in what happening, it is very sorry to say that the designer is not giving calculation. Geotechnical engineering who is designing himself is contractor and who is sab kaam karta hai. So diaphragm wall technique is very fine. It is already implemented in Bombay, in other area of India also very efficiently, but designing is very, very important. Okay. Now the other question regarding sheet piling. Sheet piling, insertion of sheet piling may require vibration. So when you vibrate sheet piling, then it may try to create vibration in surrounding area. So if the project is very big, suppose I want to construct underground metro work. Okay. Then the for that I want to construct underground work and I want to protect surrounding building and other things. So in that case only you have to go for this type of, or suppose your site is very away from Surat near seashore, then definitely sheet piling with vibration type is possible. Otherwise you have to go for some in situ type of thing or diaphragm wall type of thing only. So depending upon type of problem, depending upon type of soil, suppose you are applying sheet pile vibration and suppose there is a sandy soil is available, sandy soil with water table. So sand, water and vibration, these three will try to create liquefaction of sand. तो इंस्टेड ऑफ स्टेबिलाइजिंग दिस सॉइल लिक्विफिकेशन ऑफ सैंड फिनोमेना विल अकर एंड और पूरा तुम्हारा जो सीट पाइलिंग है उसको लेके चला जाएगा. तो मैंने करेक्ट. सो व्हाट टाइप ऑफ सॉइल इज अवेलेबल, वेर इज द लोकेशन ऑफ वाटर टेबल, व्हाट इज द सराउंडिंग बिल्डिंग, व्हाट इज द डिस्टेंस ऑफ सराउंडिंग बिल्डिंग. करेक्ट. मेनी टाइम इवन फॉर माइनर पाइलिंग वर्क बाई हेमर यूर पाइल नॉट पाइलिंग वर्क बट पाइल को टेस्टिंग करते हैं हम लोग, डायनेमिक पाइल टेस्ट करते हैं. वो टाइम पे भी बाजू का बिल्डिंग में वाइब्रेशन आता है. हमने जो डायनेमिक वाइब्रेशन टेस्टिंग जो करते हैं, ऑफकोर्स इट इज फॉर ओनली 1 सेकंड, बट वी मस्ट बी वेरी केयरफुल कि भाई बाजू में कुछ प्रॉब्लम नहीं हो जाए. देन सपोज माई ब्रिज साइड इज वेरी नियर टू एनी मल्टी स्टोरी बिल्डिंग, सपोज इन 10 मीटर डिस्टेंस, देन आई कैन नॉट इंसिस्ट दैट आप यहाँ पे भाई डायनेमिक पाइलो टेस्ट करो, क्योंकि डायनेमिक पाइलो टेस्ट में बिल्डिंग को प्रॉब्लम हो सकता है. सो देयर आर नंबर ऑफ परमिटेशन कॉम्बिनेशन और आपको देख के करना पड़ा. बट आई थिंक एज फार एज सूरत इज कंसर्न, डेफिनेटली डायफ्राम वॉल आर अ वेरी गुड सॉल्यूशन, बट डिजाइनिंग इज रिक्वायर्ड, प्रॉपर डिजाइनिंग इज रिक्वायर्ड. और मोस्टली आई थिंक आई एम नॉट श्योर बट कमिश्नर, जैसे कमिश्नर हमको बता रहे थे दैट दे मे गिव अस ग्रुप चेकिंग ऑफ आरी वॉल ऑल्सो एलॉन्ग, नॉट आरी वॉल सॉरी डायफ्राम वॉल ऑल्सो एलॉन्ग विद द टॉल बिल्डिंग कंसेप्ट. हमने बताया हम लोग कैपेबल है, बट डिजाइनर मस्ट सबमिट ऑल द ड्रॉइंग ऑल द कैलकुलेशन फॉर डायफ्राम ऑल्सो एलॉन्ग विद द टॉल बिल्डिंग कैलकुलेशन. तो हम लोग कर सकते हैं ग्रुप चेकिंग. तो अभी वो आएगा तो शायद नेक्स्ट ईयर 2021 और विद द नेक्स्ट बिल्डिंग वी मे स्टार्ट नाउ चेकिंग स्ट्रक्चरल डिजाइनिंग चेकिंग ऑफ टॉल बिल्डिंग एज वेल एज डायफ्राम वॉल ऑल्सो बिफोर कंस्ट्रक्शन एंड वी कैन सेफ गार्ड अवर सूरत सिटी. एनी अदर क्वेश्चन? नेक्स्ट. हेलो हेलो
हेलो
हेलो
हाय.
हाँ बोलो. हमें
हाँ, सो एनी अदर क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द एनी अदर क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द पार्टिसिपेंट्स?
हेलो.
हाय. यस सर. यस सर.
हाँ बोलो. चालू छे कहीं कोई ने पूछो तो पूछो, प्रश्न वादो नहीं. आई एम रेडी.
हाँ, सो एनी अदर क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द पार्टिसिपेंट? इफ यू वांट टू इंटरेक्ट विथ देसाई सर देन यू कैन डायरेक्टली अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ एंड you just you can do the interaction with Desai sir. So unmute yourself and ask your query or any question. I think six.
Hello.
Hello sir. Good morning.
Good morning.
I have asked a question regarding diaphragm wall. Thank you very much for the answer. It was very convincing. And what I have been observing in any other countries, like the designing is done by the geotechnical department and not by the structural department. Basically, there are some other bodies and it is not advisable to do with the structural designing, while they don't know that the piling and encouraging in the soil and so on. So what I have observed, I work in Germany, so here what they are doing is like the designing of a diaphragm wall or let's say any other retaining wall is done by the geotechnical department. So
here also,
what,
hello, just let me just 1 minute here also here jo what jo aapko maine bataya it was designed by geotechnical engineer only. Hello.
Okay.
Diaphragm wall, because here in Surat also kisi ke paas knowledge nahi hai diaphragm wall ka. हेलो.
ओके.
जो डिजाइनिंग की मैं बात कर रहा हूँ जियोटेक्निकल इंजीनियर ने बताया है, बट फॉर इकोनॉमी पर्पस बिकॉज ये टेक अ टर्नकी कॉन्ट्रैक्ट, तो क्या करते हैं कॉस्ट इफेक्टिव करने के लिए एक ही पिनिंग, एक ही 17 डिग्री पे एक ही पिनिंग किया, खाली डबल डबल पाइलिंग वो करने की जगह पे एक ही पाइलिंग किया जस्ट टू सेव कॉस्ट. ओके. और वो क्या बोलते हैं हमको कि भाई टेम्पररी स्ट्रक्चर है, आरसीडी स्ट्रक्चर जब भी बनता है इनसाइड फॉर वाटर फॉर वो बीम कॉलम की बनाते हैं, so then it is not a just to facilitate the underground construction ke liye diaphragm wall ka functioning, it is not a permanent structure. Even IS code ka gardi kam ka jo code hai 1893, it is not allowing to transfer any earthquake loading in diaphragm wall, very clearly likha gaya hai. Okay. हमको बिल्डिंग को तो अर्थक्वेक को सेपरेट रीजन करना है, डायफ्राम वॉल इज जस्ट टू फैसिलिटेट अ कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ साइट ओके, और वो जियोटेक्निकल इंजीनियर ही बनाते हैं, स्ट्रक्चर इंजीनियर नहीं बनाते हैं, उनको नॉलेज भी नहीं है। हेलो, लेकिन ये हमारे
बस में क्या है, आई हैव सीन द ड्राइंग ड्राइंग्स आर इश्यूड बाय द स्ट्रक्चरल डिजाइन एजेंसी, दैट्स व्हाई आई आस्क्ड दिस क्वेश्चन।
नो, आई एम सी आई एम सर, या यू आर राइट, एब्सोल्युटली राइट, बट हियर इन सूरत आई एम कनेक्टेड विद अबव 45 मीटर बिल्डिंग स्ट्रक्चर ओके। तो ये जो आपने जो क्वेश्चन किया, हमने कमिश्नर को मींस नॉट माइसेल्फ बट असेंबली ऑफिसर आल्सो से दी डायफ्राम वॉल जो बिलो 45 मीटर स्ट्रक्चर है, 10 स्टोरी बिल्डिंग है या 12 माले का बिल्डिंग है, उसके अंदर तो स्ट्रक्चरल इंजीनियर ही देता है, तो वो कैसे अभी दे ऑलरेडी ये डायरेक्शन में चालू हो गया है। सी व्हाट आई द वी हैव हाइलाइटेड प्रॉब्लम कि ये प्रॉब्लम है और ये डिजाइनिंग जियोटेक्निकल को करना है जो भी करे, बट चेकिंग इज रिक्वायर्ड अल्टीमेटली, डिजाइनिंग से ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट चेकिंग करना पड़ेगा ना उसको ओके। तो अभी हमने बिकॉज आई एम ऑलरेडी डूइंग वर्क फॉर अबव 45 मीटर ओके, अबव 45 मीटर के अंदर की चेकिंग की मैं बात कर रहा हूँ ओके, आई एम नॉट कनेक्टेड बिलो 45 मीटर। गवर्नमेंट बिल्डिंग जो बिलो 45 मीटर है उसमें उसमें दोनों कर रहे हैं, और उसके अंदर जो हमारे जो एसमिनेट टीम है, जियोटेक्निकल जो एक्सपर्ट है, वो लोग भी हमारे साथ में इन्वॉल्व है, हमारे साथ में चेकिंग में जो मैंने आपको बताया वो जो डायफ्राम वॉल गिर गया था उसका इन्वेस्टिगेशन, उसका वापस नया चेकिंग भी हमने करके दिया। तो अलॉन्ग विथ मी अनदर जियोटेक्निकल एक्सपर्ट वॉज देयर, एंड एज फार एज माई सेल्फ इज कंसर्न आई एम गाइडिंग बोथ पीएचडी स्ट्रक्चर एंड जियोटेक्निकल, दोनों पीएचडी में गाइड करता हूँ, पढ़ाता भी हूँ, तो माइक इज डिफरेंट बिकॉज आई एम 36 ईयर्स हो गए, आई एम कनेक्टेड इन बोथ थिंग, और दोनों में पढ़ाते भी हूँ और पीएचडी भी गाइड कर रहे हैं, तो दैट्स व्हाई आई कैन एबल टू गो फॉर ऑल द टॉपिक, नो प्रॉब्लम जियोटेक्निकल एंड स्ट्रक्चरल जियोटेक्निकल स्ट्रक्चर जियोटेक्निक को ही बनाना पड़ेगा बट टेक फॉर सम टाइम इन इंडिया टू इम्प्लीमेंट या
Okay. Thank you very much, sir.
Yeah, you can note down my email address and you can note down my mobile number also if you want.
Yeah, sir.
Hello. My number is 93274.
Yeah.
93274333390.
Okay.
I even in Asminity website, my mobile numbers and email address, everything available. You can refer, no problem.
I have met you, sir, some 6 years back when, also maybe 10 years back, with the reference of Hiren Desai, sir. And I was there with my father to meet you regarding my bachelor thesis. So I know you. Okay. But thank you very much, sir.
Thanks. Any other question? Darshan bhai?
Any other question?
Hello.
Any other question from the participants? If you like to ask, you can directly interact with the sir. If no, then we can conclude this session.
Okay.
Sir, maybe now I think no question from the participant.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
So on behalf of all the participants and Civil Engineering Department of Government Engineering College Surat, I would like to thank Desai sir for delivering such a wonderful and informative session regarding this, what are the recent advances going on into the geotechnical field. So, sir has various case studies in his session, and sir has also go through with various projects which he had completed, and he has also shared his experience on the various projects which he had completed. So it is a wonderful session. So far, I think all the participants on the knowledge regarding the basic as well as the theoretical. So once again, I would like to thank Desai sir for this wonderful session. So thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. Okay.
And also thankful all the participants for your kind presence during these 6 days of workshop. So now we are ending this meeting.
Okay.
Okay. So thank you so much all the participants. And thank you, Desai.
Thanks, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.